Listener discretion is advised. Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
LoveLine, coast to coast.
Hey, everybody, it's LoveLine. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew. Over there, Dr. Drew, board-certified physician, addiction medicine specialist. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Oh, finally, me and my lover with some time alone.
Isn't that true?
Yeah.
It feels almost funny.
Yeah, I was out of town for a few days, and then Drew was out of town, then I was off the air, then I was in Vegas.
Then we have guests in here, like Willie Nelson, and people to disturb our sanctity.
It's really, even, and Willie Nelson was great.
Yeah.
But it's still like being chaperoned on a date when we have a guest in here, Drew. It's like, how am I going to cop a feel?
I'm tired.
No. Got some old guy with a braid sitting across.
You gotta be creative.
Yeah. Speaking of creative, Drew's daughter has written me another letter. She's now decided that it was important that I build them a tree house at their home. I grew up in a tree house. Do you have a tree that's suitable for a tree house?
I haven't actually been out there to see what they're talking about. Think they do.
Dear Adam, please. And that's interesting because, first off, it's usually one please or three pleases. She must have ran out of steam. You know, you either get the please make a big treehouse or please. You rarely get the please.
It's a little more formal, please.
That's a creative mind there. Yeah. Make a big treehouse, please. Oh, I see.
She saved
the third please.
I'll tell you something. This girl's penmanship, spelling, and punctuation is better than mine. Absolutely. And vocabulary with the use of the three pleases. Please, make a big treehouse, please. I would really like that. It would be the funnest thing in the house. I could have my club meetings in it. Uh-oh. You got to get her away from your wife. Already thinking about them clubs. Them social clubs.
Scary.
Got to get the girls together so we can complain about guys in life.
Mm.
See, guys get together, they watch sports, they get loaded.
Yeah.
Girls get together and complain about guys getting together.
Oh, yeah.
That's really why girls' clubs were formed. Because guys won out. Guys said, hey, let's get together. Let's go to the drag races. Let's go to the motocross races. Let's throw the football around. Let's watch the game. Women said, we got to have a meeting so that we can complain about what guys do when they get together. They can't even do stuff, women, that does not involve complaining about guys. What a life that would be. I could have my club meetings in it. If you say yes, you might not. I really want you to, and this is in parentheses, I really, really want you to, and me and my friends will help you. Sidebar there.
Uh-huh.
I really hope you say yes. Ooh, that's O with four H's. I would imagine.
Wow.
It's a huge word. I would imagine how much fun it could. Oh, it's getting a little. And plus, I'm not a great reader. This could be me. Imagine how much fun in it. Okay. So you're saying she's going to have a lot of fun in the treehouse. If you make one for us, you realize kids write in circles a little bit.
Yeah.
You could always take one of their full pages and condense it down to just a thought or two.
Yeah.
Yeah, just a sentence. You put more support on it, please. Let's see. If you say yes, will you start this weekend? And come and do it at our house, please. Do you think you could do it in the front yard for the treehouse? Pretty please. Oh, I can't stop thinking about how much fun it would be. Well, I don't know if I can take. Can I bring this letter to my therapist with me?
Oh,
because
absolutely.
I keep trying to give him examples of this sort of pressure I'm under, but he never understands what I'm talking
about.
Problem
is, if your girlfriend sees it, you're going to be at our house.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus. P.S. Right back tonight at the radio and give it to my daddy. Is that Anderson or? No, that's you, right?
You better write her back, Adam.
I'm scared because what grade is she in?
Third.
My penmanship and spelling is no better than this. And my writing is slightly less legible.
She'll feel like she's getting a letter from her peer. That'll be fine. really good.
Her peers, like, would you have a
second grader,
a first grader take quotation? Okay, all right. I'm gonna write her back. All right.
This will be good.
Please, please, please leave my ass alone. No, I'll put a bid in, but it's gonna be so high that I'll be right out of the game. Okay. That's my plan.
Right.
What does a girl want a treehouse for?
She and a little group of friends decided they want it.
Okay.
A whole group of them.
I built Jimmy's kid a playhouse once years ago.
Mm.
Ari?
Hello?
You're 15?
Yeah.
What's up?
Nothing. I do Irish dancing.
Yeah? Is that Lord of the Dance kind of stuff?
Yeah.
The big wooden shoes kind of thing?
Yeah.
Right.
And I got kicked in my balls from one of the competitions about 16 days ago.
Good times.
Who kicked you? Just a upset judge?
Wayward shoe?
Something flew off? One of the dancers?
Yeah.
How does that work? How does one kick one in the balls? You mean that thing where they lift the knee up and they kick the foot straight out?
Kind of like that. It's kind of you jump with your foot straight out and then snap your feet together in the air.
Uh-huh.
Is it a competition?
Yeah.
Did that interrupt the flow of the competitive experience?
I just kept on dancing.
Oh, you didn't go down.
Oh, my God.
No.
That's too bad. I really wish you had. And just so I can get a visual. So this is one of the guys on your squad.
Yeah.
Okay, so kicked in the nuts.
I was competing against him.
Oh, right. you were competing against this guy?
Yeah.
Oh, interesting tactic, kicking in the nuts. So now what?
So now I got a competition in 6 days, and they still look pretty bad.
What does?
My balls.
Both of them?
More on the left, but yeah, they're both blue.
What? Blue.
Darker.
Not... You mean the skin's purple?
Yeah, kind of.
All right, they hurt?
Like every once in a while.
Are they swollen?
Not really.
All right, so you just really just got a sort of a superficial wound. You're all right.
He's all right.
Sounds like you're okay.
Hey, Ari.
Yeah.
What do you plan on doing with this? Is there like college scholarships or?
I'm a world champion.
Are you?
Yeah, I'm eighth in the world right now.
Out of five or how many people do this?
Geez, in the national competition in my group is like 350.
Wow. Now what is your are you like? Are you the 13 to 16 category or? Bisexual or what? Well, how do they break the categories in? Straight, gay, bi?
I'm not gay.
Oh, okay. Well, how does this work? What is your category, your grouping?
I'm grouped in 13 to 16.
Mm-hmm. Hey, don't I get a little credit for getting the 13 to 16 grouping that you were in?
Sure.
Okay, thank you. Wow,
not listen, even that. Not
here's
even
what I'm
that.
Saying. Most groupings aren't 13 to 16.
No, it's 10 to 14, 12 to 16, something like that. 13 to 16, I thought it was odd when you said that.
I thought it was odd when I said it, too. It felt like a strange mixture.
Yeah.
And in, like, Little League and stuff, it's always 13 and 14-year-olds or
it's
whatever.
Even numbers.
Or
it?
Under 18. Yeah, the 13 to 16 is a strange grouping. But obviously, I know a lot about the sport. So, Ari.
Yeah?
All right, so what do you do? You're going to go on the professional circuit when you're done with this?
I don't know. It's just kind of a hobby.
Okay.
I'm going to college.
Okay. And no, and you know, you can work now, you know, Vegas-style reviews. This thing's big in Vegas.
Maybe.
All right. Virgin?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Is this the kind of, like, are you one of these guys, do you go to high school and wear, like, some of the garb that you'd wear at the competition stuff, try to get a little attention, but the chicks don't really care?
I'm actually homeschooled.
Ooh.
I know you're going to hate that.
Oh. No. You're fine. You're fine. You're competitive. You have a lot of discipline, right?
Yeah.
How many hours a day do you work out?
Six.
Wow.
And are your parents Irish and they got you into this, or someone got the Lord of the Dance video like 4 years ago? And
my mom's Irish and she had us take it up.
Wow. All right. Okay. All right there, buddy. Good times.
Okay.
Okay.
So we'll just heal and be fine?
I think so.
Okay.
All right.
Good luck.
Okay. Thanks.
All right. Boy, that sound. There was a virgin. Okay. Let me do some virgin math here. Into dance.
You're going to give an estimate of when he's going to lose his virginity?
Yeah, he's 15. Yeah. He's 15.
He's got a squirrely voice.
Yeah, well, no, wait a minute now. Let me just... Let me do some math here. We'll see if we can work this out. He's 15, not virgin. So let's take the 15. I'm going to add I'm gonna add 2 years for being into dance in general.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to tack another 18 months onto that for being into the Lord of the Dance type dance.
How about homeschooling?
Hold on.
Oh.
I haven't got to that. So he's 15. We're at 3.5 years. So what are we at? 18 and a half? Mm-hmm. Homeschooling is, that's a year. That's a good year.
Okay, I'll give a year.
Well, you're not even, who are you screwing at home?
Right. Is there
a mailman?
Extra squirrely penalty?
Hold on a second. 3.5. We're at 19 and a half years before Ari gets laid. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to tack on another 6 months because of the competition. I mean, he's taking the dance to that level. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All right. So that is, that's 20. He'll lose it at 20. So Ari, circle that on your calendar, 2007. All right. Let's talk to Sarah here. Sarah?
Yeah?
17?
Yep, that's me.
What's up?
All right. Me and my boyfriend have this problem going on, like, with condoms breaking all the time. Like, okay. They've had to have broken somewhere between 10 and 15 times.
How come?
I really don't know. Like, it seems like we're putting them on, right? You know, you read the directions and you put them on, and we've tried all different types of condoms, but they just keep on breaking. But the question I have for you is, the reason we're wearing them, like, I'm on the pill and stuff like that, but the reason we're wearing them is to protect against STDs, but it seems like...
Who has the STD?
We don't know. Like, neither of us have been tested. It's just, like, in case any of us have it, like, we don't want to give it to the other person.
So each of you had other partners?
Yeah.
How many?
It's just me and him together right now, but, like, we've been with other people.
How many?
How many other people?
Yeah.
Like, I've been with, like, I don't know, 10 other people, protected and stuff, but it's still, like, you never know. But my question is, like...
You do know. You know if you have an HIV, if you have a disease.
You use protection, and you know who your partners were, and...
Do you get pap smears regularly?
What was that?
Do you get regular pap smears?
I haven't had one in a while, but yeah, like...
And they've never told you have an infection?
No, they haven't. Her line's bad, so she's bothering me. No, they never said anything. Hey, Sarah?
Yeah?
Pap smears come out okay?
Yeah.
Where would you contract? Where in the meantime would you have contracted an STD?
Not while we were together, just before we were together.
Yeah, but you've had pap smears.
Yeah, okay, hold on. I'm done with the over obvious stuff. We understand that whole concept. You don't know exactly where his penis has been. He doesn't know exactly where your vagina has been. But you've used protection. You've had a limited amount of partners. Your pap smears have come up good. You have no outbreaks or anything like that.
No symptoms.
Yeah.
See, the non-IV drug users, what are they thinking?
This is what, I'll tell you what they're thinking. They're thinking what the goddamn pussies have shoved up their ass from all this Project AIDS and all these other nonsense organizations. You all could get it. Anyone could get it. You never know what you have when you sleep with someone. No, that's ridiculous. You do know what's going on. You know, there's high-risk groups, you retards. Liz Taylor would like you to believe that just... You know, and it's all this stuff like use a condom every time, every partner, every day. You know, it's like, no, that's not the way. Listen, you're banging some guy in the ass in the back of some bar that's done up like a dude ranch. You sure as hell better wear a condom. You're some kid who's 17 and you're growing up in Nebraska and you've had two partners and no one has a disease. And this, you know, your partners weren't gay or bi or anything. You're fine. You're on the pill. Everything's coming up fine. It just drives me. That kind of brainwashing bothers
me. Well, the reality is that the reason, I believe, there's a reason now that young people are not using condoms. They really are not using them very regularly. And the reason is what I call a sort of reefer madness mentality.
Yes.
We've taught them, we can't have a rational conversation about marijuana because we told young people at one time that marijuana would kill them, turn them all into heroin addicts. And they believed that for about 5 minutes and then went, hey, wait a minute, that's BS. And then now you can't talk about it anymore.
Well, they won't listen to you.
They will not listen to you. And so that's exactly what's happened with condoms now. This notion that everybody all the time is going to give you HIV, they looked around and went, wait a minute, it's not happening.
No, there's
so therefore, I'm not going to listen to anything you say.
No one in my high school has it. Yeah. Right, yes. And then they start pulling out, you know, they start pulling out statistics worldwide that involve lots of parts of deepest, darkest Africa, then try to include you in that. You know, males 18 to 34, the highest growing group, heterosexual males. Yeah, in Uganda. What else do you want to tell me about? You want to tell me about some indigenous bug that I have to worry about the bite of that doesn't exist on this goddamn continent? It just stop it. That's all. Listen.
It's be accurate. Be 100% accurate.
AIDS,
because you overstate it, and young people will reject what
AIDS,
you have to say.
Right. I'm not saying AIDS is a good thing, and I'm not saying that people don't need to protect themselves against it. But just give us the straight information, and let us make responsible decisions based on accurate data. Don't try to scare everyone into everything. And it's so funny that the people that go nuts with this AIDS BS are the same people that were going nuts during the Reefer Madness era on the other side of the government's Reefer Madness.
Yeah, that's interesting.
These are the left-wing pussies who were pounding and yelling, this propaganda, this is brainwashing, this is the government spinning this whole reefer thing out of control. These are now the people that are spinning the whole AIDS thing out of control.
Interesting.
Yeah.
And the people that would like random searches. Which I get subjected to every time I go in the airport.
Oh, yeah, right.
Not protect against terrorism.
Right. Let's pick out all the chicks that look like Sandy Duncan and put a metal-detecting baton up her ass. Make sure she's not carrying any explosives. Michelle?
Yeah?
You're 27?
I am.
Hey, what's up?
What's going on?
Hey, how do?
Very well.
All righty.
Wanted to start out that I've been listening to you guys for 7 years.
Great.
Wow. Something must be wrong with me.
Yeah, how can we help?
Actually, I have a question about Depakote and the side effects of Depakote.
Mm-hmm.
Have been diagnosed bipolar about a month ago and have only been on it for a month. Wondering if there are any sexual side effects that I should expect?
No.
Or should look for?
No. Is it something you're happening?
No, not at all.
No, Depakote is not an antidepressant per se. It's a mood stabilizer.
Right.
And it's a whole different range of side effects. It's rash and liver inflammation and anemia and things that they're going to detect on blood tests more than anything else.
Okay. My other question is, and I don't know if you know the answer, why is it that the majority of people who are diagnosed bipolar, it happens in their 20s?
Because that's when it comes on. The people that do research on this look at the brain activity. The best way I can explain it to you, imagine a brain seizure where there's like lots and lots of brainwave activity. And people with bipolar have a predisposition to these little sort of bursts of hyper brain activity. And if those bursts are stimulated a sufficient number of time by a sufficient certain age, then it becomes sort of self-sustaining. It's like you're like kickstarting a car, like brum, 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 and now it's going. Mm. And that has a window with, if you get enough of these little kickstarts between basically 18 to 22, then pow, now it goes and it stays, keeps going.
All right, let's talk to, you like this call?
Yeah.
All right. Stephanie?
Hello?
You're 22?
Yes.
What's up?
I had a question for Dr. Drew. I am 22 years old, and I have two children, a five-year-old and a one-and-a-half-year-old. And ever since I had my youngest son, I am just, like, not attractive to my husband. I hate having sex with him, and I know it's normal to a certain extent.
Wait, you're not attracted, or you're not attractive?
That's what she meant. She meant attracted.
Well, he's still attractive to me, yes, but I don't like to have sex. I find him, he's very handsome. He is. But kiss me if you want, touch me if you want, but don't have sex with me. Don't ask me for sex. And it wasn't like that. We were very sexually active, 3-4 times a day. And if possible, even more.
All right, hold on. Stop.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. Any sexual abuse in your past?
You know, not that... I don't know if...
Hold on a second. Wait. Recreate.
LoveLine.
Reenactment.
Reenactment. Go ahead.
Listen, Stephanie, any sexual abuse in your past?
Well, no. Yeah. I don't... you got to... No. It with aunt, uncle, no. Wow. We didn't even get to the part where she answered, did we?
No, I don't think she ever got it out.
All right. Stephanie?
Hello.
Any sexual abuse in the past?
Not that I remember of. I'm it did happen to my sisters, and I possibly blocked it off. Is that possible?
Oh yes, that's quite possible.
Okay. You say sisters. You had more than one sister.
I have two sisters, yes, two older sisters.
Was this your dad or your grandfather or uncle or what was it?
It was my uncle.
Great.
My mom's brother. And it was possibly, I feel very uncomfortable around my father. I love him and he's a perfect dad, but I do feel very uncomfortable. And with men in general.
Well, what happens with that history is sometimes you get on a trajectory and you can become on a hypersexual trajectory. You can get sort of shut down. And having children sometimes is a way of evoking a lot of your ambivalent feelings from the past.
Interesting.
And so here you have little kids around and a lot of these feelings. And now your husband starts representing that guy that abused the kids. And maybe he is even a guy like that because we might predict you might pick someone like that.
Okay.
Well, let me ask a couple of questions. Your sisters are both older.
Yes.
How much older?
5 and 6 years older.
Okay. And you say you loved your dad very much. He was a great dad, but you're uncomfortable around him.
Well, now he's a great dad, yes. He wasn't when I was younger.
Right.
He's a recovery alcoholic.
Yeah. Oh, okay. So, and you do, for a fact, know that your mom's brother got hold of your two sisters.
Yes.
But never did find out if he got hold of you, huh?
No.
And how did they deal with that? Is he still in the life of your mother?
He lives in L.A.
Great. See if I can run him over on the way home.
Yeah. And I'm really not... We didn't really cope. I went to see a psychiatrist for a while.
Yeah.
But that was shortly after I noticed that they wanted to put me in antidepressants and whatnot. I just didn't want to go that way, and I canceled.
Okay.
I stopped going. Yeah.
All right. Don't let them treat you. Smart. All right. Here's the thing, now, Stephanie. I completely agree with Drew. You had an alcoholic dad. You had sisters that were abused. Possibly you were abused. You grew up in a situation where this was just, you know, your mom was part of this. This was her brother. God knows what her brother did to her and what her dad.
Yeah, he did it to her too.
Fantastic.
There you go.
Yeah, there you go. This is a mess. And you should have a whole bunch of feelings, and don't worry about the sexual part of it. And on your kids' behalf, because you don't want them to, if they go through 1/10 of what your family went through, consider yourself a failure as a parent. All right?
Okay.
All right. Go back into therapy.
No, it's not okay. It's a sign that things are not okay, and it's time to get back into some treatment. And then, well, wouldn't you say too? We'd sort of worry about her choice in a mate, even.
He's very handsome.
You'd expect him
He's a good looker.
Expect him to be a
matinee good looks, I'll tell you. Matinee idol. Oh, Stephanie didn't sound like she was sure if the world was round or flat.
Right.
And listen, I don't blame her. Let me ask her. Stephanie?
Gone.
Did she hang up? Yeah, I worry a little about her husband.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I was just talking to my sister today. I couldn't imagine going over there and banging my two nephews.
Not today, anyway.
Well, she moved out to Topanga. I'm not driving that far. If they came over to my place.
If you live with them or something, then sure.
I could see meeting them halfway, like Tarzana, and maybe having one of the kids. But no, not driving all the way up there.
Of course.
That's what I meant. Why?
I just want to clarify.
I didn't want to come off like I wouldn't do it. Yeah. I have great love for the kids. I'm just saying... And we always talk about this, and just imagine this, everybody. Here you are now. You've had at your sister sexually growing up, right? And then later on, when she's old enough, becomes an adult, gets in a relationship, old enough to fend for herself and fend you off. Don't worry. You bide your time. She'll have some kids one of these days. And your sister, and then your sister finally cranks out a couple of kids, and they have at them. That's nice. And now you're just living somewhere in L.A., and you're going to work. You walk around every day. Yeah, bang my sister, and then my nephews and nieces. Yeah, that's nice. I can't remember if I got the one kid, but I know I got the other two girls. What is that? You just walking around that way? That's fine with you? At what point don't you just put a gun in your mouth? Can't you guys, all you guys have done this, can't you just go ahead and do that? Just put a bullet in your head? Salvage that one last act of dignity in a horrible, horrible life. Go ahead. Just kill yourselves. That's fine. I don't have any problem with that. We got to save these guys. What do you got to do? What's your big plan? Stay around long enough to get at one of the grandkids now, or what do you do? It's absolutely amazing, and that's why the Stephanies of the world can't be having more.
Mm-mm.
No more kids.
Mm-mm.
Okay.
Hey, you ballless fags, just kill yourselves, would you?
Yeah, please do this. Do everyone a favor, and not only all of us, but yourself. Do yourself a favor and kill yourself. Please kill yourself. We'll be back.
Hello? Is this LoveLine?
Call 1-800-LOVE-191. Adam and Dr. Drew will be right back.
Hey, how do? LoveLine. I'm Adam, and that's Drew, and the phone number is 1-800-LOVE-191. Alrighty then. Ready to get back to them phones, Drew?
I'm ready.
Alrighty. Let's talk to Craig. Craig's 30.
Hi.
Hey.
Hi, Adam.
Hiya, Greg.
Hi, Dr. Drew.
Greg.
I had a question for you. I was very curious. This is good radio. I was very curious. How many times does a clitoris quivers in a half a second?
Oh, I thought this was one of those woodchuck chuck type things, only substituting the woodchuck for the clitoris.
He's an idiot.
What is he talking about?
How many times does the clitoris do what?
Quiver.
Quiver. During, the course of a lifetime or a day or a year?
An orgasm.
He's an idiot. What's a quiver?
I don't know. What's a clitoris quiver, Greg?
A motion back and forth.
Do you know that it does that?
Well, you're a Jenna Jameson fan, right?
Yeah.
Remember Priceless? Priceless.
Yeah, with Peter North?
Yeah, Peter North.
Yeah, remember that one? Sure.
And, Mr. Rubberman. remember when Jenna was performing oral sex on, I forgot her name, and her...
Yeah, I fast forward through the lesbian stuff, usually.
Well, but he's about to tell us what a quiver is, though.
Yeah, sorry, go ahead.
Well, it's emotional back and forth.
Right, so you're saying she has that ability?
Well, I have the DVD of that, release, and I have the A and B button on my... DVD and slow motion button.
He's an idiot.
And, you know, I always sap it to that second.
All right, hold on a second.
What is going on?
Well, this is what happens.
Oh, my God.
I got myself a couple of DVDs, and it is just goddamn dangerous.
It's like, oh, my God.
You know why? Because the only thing more humiliating than, grown man just sitting in front of his big screen beating off is beating off in slow motion or stop action or that A and B where this one button you hit where it reverses 5 seconds and then reverses 5 seconds and revert, you know, you keep hitting this button. It's amazing. I mean, I'm like a replay official in the NFL. I got my head under the hood over there. I'm slow motion from 100 different angles. It's humiliating.
Do you have a penis repair kit or something there in case things pull it right off?
Registered nurse.
A nurse that was standing by. That's good. Okay. I feel better.
Yeah. Yeah. I got to talk to Greg about where his life is heading. Greg?
What?
What are you doing for a living?
I'm the guy with the red pubic hair.
Oh, he's an idiot.
I see. He's
a clown?
So you're quite comfortable.
You remember me.
No, did we talk about your red pubes?
Well, you made fun of me because I was molested and... You know the story.
Oh, wait. No, I don't think I made fun of you because you were molested.
Let's get off the subject.
This guy, yeah.
Was I here?
Yeah, I don't remember. Hey, Drew, were you here when this guy was getting all angry? We're trying to talk to him about something.
Was I here?
I think
yeah,
you were
the
here.
Guy that said that he gets his pubic hairs from the guy that molested him because his molester was redheaded.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
We were all very nervous.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Got it. Got it.
Actually, right. Asked Damien where he was calling from.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Right.
I recall now. Okay.
All right, Greg. You listen. Take care of yourself. I don't know about the clitoral.
Well, let's address it. Let's in deference to Greg.
Why?
Well, because
it
men,
doesn't exist.
You know what?
Does it?
No, because men have real confusion about that anatomy. What does contract are the muscles of the floor of the pelvis, basically the muscles that you would contract to interrupt the flow of urine.
Right.
And if, you know, when that constricts, you can see a little movement of the front part of the genitalia, but it's not anything actually happening there. It's just sort of pulling down.
Right.
The actual constriction is that the vaginal walls will close in.
All right.
And the perineum contracts.
Hey, Greg?
Yeah.
All right. There's your answer there, buddy.
Hey. Adam, I love you.
Love you, buddy. Now, buddy. Take care of yourself.
All right, Greg.
All right.
There we go.
Well, there you go. We got off on the wrong foot last time he called.
Now we've healed.
Now he loves me.
It's all better.
Hey, he's the guy that said that you weren't white.
Oh, whatever.
He said you're not even white, remember?
Yeah.
Good times.
Hey, Jesse?
Yeah.
You're 27?
Yeah.
What's up?
I've got two things to talk to you about.
All right.
First off, it's more of a political question, if you don't mind. President Bush said today that anyone who is buying illegal drugs, I'm assuming that's including marijuana, is in support of terrorism. And I wanted to know both of your views on that.
I think it's a brilliant marketing campaign.
Yeah. I mean, it's a little spurious, but all right. I mean, listen, when you buy anything black market-wise, the money goes to people who are, you know, essentially what the mafia was 70 years ago during a prohibition. You know what I mean? And the money's going into the wrong hands. Doesn't necessarily mean it's going to blow up commercial jetliners.
I mean, well, if you're buying heroin, you're probably heading back that direction.
A certain percentage of certain drugs is probably heading into a part of the region, a part of the world that we don't want the money to go to.
I mean,
the other hand, I would say to Bush, hey, you and your goddamn Texas oil buddies could have got us some domestic oil in this country and explored alternative fuels instead of sending billions of dollars into that part of the world.
That's my point.
You
exactly.
Retard.
I'm in Austin and West Texas.
Of course. There's enough oil out there in the Gulf of Mexico, so we don't have to peddle all this money to the Middle East. So, and it's guys, it's the Bushes and the Bush the Bush family that is keeping, making sure that a lot of these old policies stay in place and a lot of these oil guys get rich. So, I would ask him that question. What's worse, me buying a dime bag? Or you with your our continued reliance on fossil fuels that you guys have made sure we've been reliant on for 30 years now.
But the
thank you.
Al Qaeda and terrorist organizations are not connected to oil money.
We've got
You know, it's funny. People use the F word on the air, and then they're like, "Yeah, pardon my French." Anyway, let me keep going with my point.
Yeah.
Like,
no,
you can't keep going when you use the F word.
That's
now.
It.
I was kind of curious about his point, though. I know Anderson doesn't like it, but he said they blocked off the borders on 911. See, this is where it all goes south. Here's the problem with everybody in every group, as we always talked about.
They go to extremes.
They all go nutty.
Yeah.
They all go nutty. There's that group of Americans that... Smooth move, X-Lax.
Nice.
There's that... Drew snuck the can off the console here. There's that group of Americans who think... Not only do Americans and the CIA and the government run things that are sort of, under the table kind of stuff abroad, which they do, but they're actually against the United States. Right. The CIA and the FBI, you know what their plan is?
Overthrow the government.
Overthrow them.
The man.
They are the man. Yeah. Yeah, they want to tap you, man, because they want to know what you're thinking, man. They want to know what you're talking. No, they're against us. See, that's where the paranoia comes in.
And I was sitting at dinner the other night, and some woman starts going, "And we're giving up our rights, and we can." I thought, "Oh, you're an attorney."
Right.
I never met her before. I said, "You're an attorney," because a rational person, the people whose really rights we're concerned about, will stop that from happening.
Yeah. It's like I said, every time you worry about the government attacking its country. I'll look at it this way. I was basically saying this, and then we'll move on and help the kiddies. Look at this country as a corporation. Let's just say we're, I like to use my automotive analogies. Let's use that. Let's just say we're Ford, and, you know, Europe is a GM, and Japan can be a Nissan, and the Middle East, that can be a Chevy or something like that, right? Even though Chevy's owned by GM. But let's just keep it going this way. We do things that are good for Ford.
Yeah.
And once in a while, just like a corporation, we're willing to screw a couple employees and a couple of people in other corporations, and even our own every once in a while. But overall, we do what's best for Ford.
Yeah.
We're not interested in screwing our own company. That's what people think. I mean, they think, yeah, the FBI, they're trying to screw the citizens of the United States. No, they're not. They're not against. This is their company.
Yeah.
They got to make sure this company prospers or they're going to be out of a gig. They'll screw other people. And once in a while, they'll screw some lower level guys, like they'll lay off some guys and do some crap like that. But ultimately, they're looking out for Ford. Thank you. John?
Yeah.
You're 20?
Oh, boy.
Yeah, hi. How's it going, Adam? Okay, I have this girlfriend that I've been seeing for a year and a half. And when we started going out, she had this boyfriend. I had a girlfriend, too, and she had a boyfriend who's been she's been seeing for 3 years. And I guess she got with me because she was ready to stop seeing this guy because he's a total loser. He's like a stoner and stuff.
And she was with this total loser for 3 years.
Yeah, three years.
She must have found something appealing in him, right?
Yeah, I don't know. I think, well, she was in high school and she started seeing him.
So she was for 3 years, she must have been confused, deluded, hallucinating.
Exactly.
Oh, I see. Okay. All right. How old is he?
She is 18.
Okay. How old is he?
20.
How old is he?
He is about 20.
My mom's 44. Okay.
What's your question?
Okay. Well, anyway, recently she's been seeing him because since she's been going out with him for 3 years, I guess she kind of, you know, developed a good relationship with him, like a friendship kind of thing. And recently she's been like hanging out with him when he comes down from school. He goes to school up north. And, you know, I was always cool with that and everything. Like, he'd come down, she'd hang out with him and everything. But when we were going out for 3 months, like, she kind of, like, hung out with him.
Fooled around, yeah.
That kind of killed my trust, you know?
Yeah, how'd you find out they fooled around?
She told me. She told me everything.
Well, no.
In a way, I do trust her.
So her delirium recurred?
No. She just tells me.
No, but I mean, this delirium that causes her to seek this loser.
What's delirium?
All right, well, look. Hey, John. Okay, so now what?
Okay, now, well, every time she hangs out with him and stuff, she tells me everything, you know, like, he's having a crappy life and everything, and he needs her, you know, to be there.
Oh, yeah.
And she tells me, like, she hugs him and stuff, and, you know, she'll kiss him on the cheek, bye, but, you know.
Okay,
so, you know,
John, quiet down there, John. Now listen to me.
I'm getting my question, like, right now.
All right, hold on, then, idiot. I want to smack this kid, shake him like a paint can. First off, what chick is, I know it's not quite the right terminology, but what broad's ballsy enough to do this? You got an ex-boyfriend, you get popped screwing around with the ex-boyfriend, anybody knows, okay, now it's over. I mean, no way. Would you have balls big enough to tell your wife, oh yeah, now we're hanging out again?
Yeah, it's just a friend.
Yeah, like we were going out and 3 months into our relationship, I got busted for screwing around with this ex.
But now
it's been 6 months, so
yeah, don't worry,
we're just hugging. That's major waivers.
Look, now that here's the insanity of it. It's like, I'm telling you everything. I'm being truthful. As though by being truthful, it excuses any and all behaviors.
Right.
Well, I'm telling you the truth.
Okay, listen. We're going to get back. I'm going to yell at John for just a moment.
Excellent.
And then we'll move on.
You know what I'm saying out there?
Adam and Dr. Drew will be right back on Loveline.
Hey, yeah,
woohoo,
yeah, all right, Hey, man, maybe a little lightning round tonight.
We have not had one in quite some time.
Yeah, blah, 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 blah,
funny, the last time we had I really couldn't even understand.
I could tell you, but I'd have to kill you. Do a little something called Heiny Wine. Yeah. Yeah, give that date out. How about another traffic report, all you retards? Please tell us what's going on in Riverside and Pomona. Please. Please, I'm dying. Sitting at home. Idiots. 65 degrees. They say it's going to cool down to 62 by 5. Blah, blah. Then the sun. You know what time the sun's coming up? Blah, 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 blah. Yeah. Is there a goddamn thing you could change about any of the information I give you? Blah, 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 blah. Blah, blah. It's 9 o'clock straight up. That's 1 hour from 10. Oh, hold on. Let me get my scratch pad, you tards. Keep the nonsense coming so we don't have to talk about anything.
As opposed to what you're doing right now?
Blah, 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 blah.
Good. All right, John. So, yes. So we don't think it's okay that she should hang out with the ex-boyfriend. In fact, we think that's incredibly ballsy.
So,
though there's a lot more about her than you're willing to accept.
So you need to lay the law down.
Yeah, I expect,
I know we can discuss this forever and ever, but we'll run out of time before I get to ask my true question, but okay, without breaking up with her, you know, we both love each other very much and we're very honest. Yes, without breaking up with her, what can I do to solve this problem and not, contain this jealousy, anger feeling.
All right,
all right.
My suspicion. Go ahead.
And the answer.
Yeah. Almost ready for one. But listen, John.
Yeah.
Did she get high with him, or did she?
She used to a lot, but she doesn't do anything.
All right. That's what I'm getting here. She's an addict. Is it pot primarily her drug?
No.
What do they do? What drug?
She smoked pot at the beginning of high school, and she's already out of high school.
What drug was she doing with her boyfriend?
She used to tweak, until senior year, she never did it anymore.
All right, John, there's no such thing as a used to anything. You either are an addict or you are not. Maybe you used to have a particular drug of choice, but you're still an addict. She's an addict. He's an addict. They share their disease together. She's going back to it. She's drawn into it. The only way that there's going to be any change, you're not going to be able to change her. You can change yourself. You can go to Al-Anon. That might wake her up. It also might get you disengaged from this messy situation, which is indeed a mess. She's an addict.
And John, and listen, that what can I do and not break up, because we're very much in love. We're both very truthful.
Yeah.
That's just nonsense BS.
Yeah.
Listen, you got a handful here, and you got to be prepared to break up if she doesn't take care of business. That's the only thing you can use.
But she shared her disease with that other guy. They got high together.
Yeah.
And this kid's just the codependent that supports her, but she's got to be supported in her disease, and that's getting back with the old guy.
Blah, 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 blah. David?
Yeah.
David, 20 years old. Blah, 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 blah.
Yeah.
Blah.
Oh, sorry about that. First off, Adam, I just want to say I get a kick out of listening to you at night. So.
Blah, Sam's going to ride back up Saturday.
Anyway, yeah. Well, I do have this question for you, Dr. Drew, about AIDS.
Yeah.
I heard that when you have it, there's little purple spots that you'll see on skin.
Well, if you get Kaplan's sarcoma.
Really? Well, my question is then, I've noticed these little purple spots that I have on my skin.
Do you have HIV?
I don't think I do.
All right,
I've been tested a few different times, and I'm wondering if that's not it, what else it could be.
Well, they're purple spots that are normal. You take aspirin or anti-inflammatories or anything?
Not usually.
Somebody'd have to look at them, David. You're purple. It just bruises. Sometimes.
Well, no, I know it's not a bruise. It's really like a bright colored purple, and I've had them for, you know.
Where do you have them?
Well, I have one on my stomach, on the left side of my stomach, and I have one up on my chest.
Oh, no, those are normal. Uh-oh. Those are arteriovenous malformations. They're normal. Or venous legs. They're normal.
I had that in my eyelids once after I was heaving all night.
That's a little different. It's petechiae. That's busted blood vessels. This is a normal, stable growth he's got.
Oh, slept in my driveway. Made it up to my bed. Had gravel in my cheek from sleeping on the driveway. I was 16.
Now that would kill you.
Heaved many times.
You know what I'm saying? You would not survive that now.
No, I wouldn't. Would
if you did, you'd have to take like 6 weeks off.
I was heaving and heaving and heaving. Oh, spent the whole day in bed. And, yeah, my eyelids were just completely screwed the next day. I blew them out from dry heaving so many times.
I'm so proud.
Yeah. Hey, David?
Yeah.
Already talked to you. Yeah. We're done with you.
Dude.
Yeah. All right, dude. Well, Drill is out of the level.
10:53 and 50 seconds. Below.
Let me tell you what's on tap. Traffic, weather, sir, news. And we'll be breaking in for news every and we'll be standing by with and we'll be shooting to LoveLine 1 helicopter up there. The slow and go.
Here it is. Bottom line, it sucks being single today. Tons of lame people and no decent prospects. Call the Dateline. Call the Dateline. Call the Dateline.
1-877-889-DATE.
Loveline!
Loveline will be right back, so get your problems ready. Ready.
Everybody, Loveline. I'm Adam. That's Drew over there. All right, let's. What the hell is this call, Drew?
We've had him before.
Okay. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191, and let's get back to the phones. Speak to Shakita.
It's Shakita. I thought you said Ida or something. Never mind. Anyway, my question is for Drew, because I had called before. I don't know if y'all remember me or not. I had called before about the Filthy Sanchez and then about the hot call. And y'all had to know what the hot call was, but that don't even matter because I ain't worried about it no more. But anyway, my question was because, see, when me and my boyfriend is having sex, and, like, he is, in me or whatever. And, like, I like to push, you know, because for whatever reason, you know, it feels good. I was wondering what the long-term, like, effects of that could be. You know what I'm saying?
Hold on a second. Now, the beauty of radio is it's sort of theater of the mind.
Yeah.
I'm picturing a Cameron Diaz type.
Yeah.
Sort of leggy, blonde, blue-eyed.
What's a male, though? Yeah.
Oh.
You okay?
Cameron Diaz is not. Is that Cameron? That's a girl.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. But a male version of that. I'm. Well,
yeah. Right. Right.
Yeah. Either that or. Yeah.
Right. Shakita.
Yeah, I'm here.
Right. This is Shakita, the guy, right?
Yeah. Yes, I am a male.
And you're gay, right?
Yes, that is correct.
All right, and now the Dirty Sanchez was explained last time.
Yeah, it was something with like a figure.
All right, right.
But what's the Dirty Carl?
The hot Carl. Was one y'all never even answered for me. Y'all said y'all came back, see, because y'all put me on hold for break, and then y'all came back for break, and y'all even wasn't even interested in me. I could tell because y'all was being tired of me or whatever, and I was like, okay, because y'all didn't even explain it to me. Y'all just cut me off.
Well, we didn't know what the answer was, and we may have run out of time, but I'm very interested in you, Shakita, as I am in all my listeners.
I hope so, and I told y'all last time that there is definitely not enough black people calling here, because I told you guys last time, y'all, I don't know if y'all is racial discriminatory or whatever
Drew
it is.
Drew doesn't like blacks.
Well, it's just something there ain't enough of them calling. It's just not like a racial thing, you know. I think that more of them should be calling, that's all.
Well, I know people do kind of feel that way in life. We need more of these people doing this and more of those people doing that. And, like, we got a lot of black airport guys, but we don't have enough black cops or firemen. I've accepted that there's certain things white folks gravitate toward, and there's certain things that black folks gravitate toward. And
but what's the wrong with gravitating that? Toward, like, some information about sex? There's nothing wrong with that. It has nothing to do with everybody's interested in that.
I absolutely, and I wish all 33 million black Americans listen to this show. I absolutely do. I have no problem with that. But I don't feel like we have to curtail the show to get this certain group or go after them in any way. We'll just do as good a show as we can do, and hopefully...
Well, you guys do a very good job.
Thank you.
And you know, Drew, you know you be a fire bed. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, he's tight.
He is. I bet he is.
And low mileage rectally.
Low mileage.
Very hell low. Yeah, brand new.
But I like pushing. Yeah.
His ass still has that new ass smell.
Nice. Like a new car, but yeah, still that's like a new ass.
But it's ass, yeah.
Right,
and, but,
that's right. I like that smell.
And let me tell you something, too, Shakita. Drew, passionate, passionate man.
I think I've covered this, okay? I've been listening for long enough. You was a millionaire, literally. And
literally.
Passionate, passionate man.
Passionate man. And let me give you, and Drew, don't chime in.
All right.
Okay, here's what I think about Drew from a homosexual standpoint. He's not gay, and I wouldn't expect him to be gay, but because he's a passionate man, I think once he got started, he'd finish. Do you know what I'm
like
saying, Shakita?
Once you got me in? Or in me?
I need them to finish for me.
Once you got Drew going, I believe he would keep going. That's what I'm saying.
I can get you going, Drew.
That's what I believe. That's what I believe. You are the primer.
I'm the primer.
You would get Drew going. And being a passionate, passionate man, he's like one of these guys who's, you know, like these guys who have gay sex in prison. They're not gay. They got a lot of love.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying.
And once they get going, they get going.
I understand. It makes perfect sense. Drew, right. You up for it?
I think I'm falling in love.
I think you are, too. I think you are, too.
And not only that, what a feather it would be in your cap to have a doctor.
I know. A white, rich doctor.
A white, rich doctor.
Well,
you'd
need to bring the millionaire along, so you'd have to come. Man.
That is great.
Right, right. And, you know, if I don't know how your family is with your lifestyle, but I bet it would be, I bet they'd be okay once they caught Drew pulling up.
You know what? I bet they would, too. We could drive up in, like, one of them Escalades all tripped out, you know what I'm saying, with the drink holders. Hell yeah.
Yeah, yeah. You see, that there's, see, black trumps gay because... The black drives the Escalade, but the gay wants the convertible.
Well,
see, but
yeah.
You said Escalade.
They haven't invented, though. You go convertible Escalade just yet. So
yeah, but that would be good, right?
Hell yeah, that would be good. Catching some sun, you know, because my skin can take it, you know.
Right.
My skin can't take y'all pasty and y'all be getting skin cancer. Born for the sun. Oh, I think I said S word here.
Almost. Yeah. Almost. It's an unbelievable story.
Yeah, all right. All right, Shakita.
All right, we're calling. Was that Willie Nelson? Oh, how about that?
That was Willie Nelson. All right.
It's an unbelievable story.
Well, Shakita and you and Drew make a nice couple.
Can't
see
you see
we
it
can
now?
Do with
I
that.
Can see it. We never answered this question about him causing a problem by pushing while he's being entered.
Well, listen.
I don't see where there's a problem there, particularly.
You also run the risk on this show if you want to talk about ancillary subjects such as the Dirty Sanchez. You run the risk of us rambling on too long in your dream homosexual relationship with Dr. Drew and that kind of stuff, of us never getting to your question. Bobby?
Yeah.
You're 18?
Yes, sir.
Be fair, that happens almost no matter what.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's true.
All right, Bobby. What's up?
My question is, every time I'm about to have sex, right,
yeah,
I can't get erect. And I don't do drugs. I'm not on any medication at all. I don't smoke. I just want to know if there's anything wrong with me. I mean,
how many times has this happened?
It's happened like every single time.
You're gay. How many times?
I'm not gay.
How many times?
This has been like 5 or 6 times.
And it's been with a different woman each time?
It's been different each time. And I'm not gay. I mean...
What about trying to get it together with a single person you start to sort of work it out with?
I'm in a relationship right now. And then you know, every single time I try to have sex with her, I just can't.
Right, let's do the math again, Bobby. You said it's happened 5 times.
Yeah.
And every single time it's been with a different woman.
Yes.
So you've only tried it once with your current girlfriend.
Yeah.
Okay, why don't you keep trying to work it out with her? It'll be,
only our callers are stupid enough to count once as every time.
Yeah, right.
But technically they're right.
That's right, yeah.
But they will still phrase it that way.
I know.
Every time I've tried to have sex with this girl, I can't get an erection. How many times did you try? Once. That is 100%.
It's every time.
It's like... Every time I flip a coin, it lands on tails. How many times you flip a coin? Once. What did it land on? Tails?
Every time.
Well, you know what?
Each and every time.
I think they beat us on a technicality.
Yeah.
All right, well, you miss Bobby. You need this. Listen to us. Settle in with this girl and find your rhythm and your groove. Don't freak yourself out. Don't put too much pressure on yourself. Just find your groove.
Try to be comfortable with her. Just kind of see what happens.
All right, buddy. It'll work its way out. Believe you me. Have confidence, my brother.
All right.
Thank you.
Oh, he's like revived. Oh, Adam, thank you. God bless you.
Megan?
Yeah.
You're 17?
Yes.
What's up?
Well, I have a problem. I met this guy that's really cool, but he's Mexican, and I'm Caucasian, and my dad is really racist. Mm-hmm. And I know this guy really likes me, and I don't want to date him, but I at least want to hang out with him, and I've never had a friend of another race, and I don't know how to talk to my dad about this.
Where did you meet him?
I go to this club regularly every weekend.
How did your dad become such a racist, and what's that all about?
Well, he claims it started when he said that he didn't used to be, but his 18-year-old brother picked up a hitchhiker, and he was black, and he stabbed him to death. Mm. And that was when my dad started to become racist, or that's what he said.
He had to sort of generalize his rage at everyone that looked like that one guy.
Well, did he, does this count for the Mexicans, too?
Yeah, he doesn't like blacks, Mexicans, Indians, nothing.
Why does he have to know that you're hanging out with this guy?
Well, because, right now it's not a big deal, but he just recently started calling my house. And I wanted to be able to actually go out and do things with him.
Uh-huh. Does a guy got what's the guy's name?
It's
you don't have to give me his last name. Is his name Sanchez, or has he got a normal name?
It's Kyle.
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 He's not a Mexican alive named Kyle.
But well, he is. He's Mexican, half Mexican and half Indian. But he looks pretty Mexican. And
what kind of Indian?
I think Native American.
Oh, all right.
You think Native American?
Well, see, I haven't met his parents yet.
But you don't know if it's...
I'm not sure, but he doesn't look like he's mixed with the other kind. So I'm just going based on what he looks like.
Middle Eastern. I mean, the 7-Eleven type Indian, right?
Right.
Okay. Nothing wrong with the stereotype, Drew.
Is his last name Singh?
You in love with this guy?
No, I mean, I have a little bit of a crush on him, but I don't want to, date him.
Is his last name Singh or, Trotting Bull?
it's a Mexican last name.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Hmm.
All right, okay. All right, you think, I mean, is your dad a bad guy besides the racism part?
He's pretty, I don't know, he might go over the deep end.
Really?
Where's my bourbon?
Yeah, my dad's kind of psycho.
Well, what about you dating in general?
Oh, well, he really doesn't throw as big of a fit about it as I thought he would. He's really pretty good about it.
About the dating?
Uh-huh.
Where's your mom? Can she help you sort of buffer this thing?
Well, I talked to her about it, and she's pretty much made it clear that bringing up dating would not be a good thing. But she told me to talk to Dad about it, but then she contradicts herself at the same time.
About dating?
Well, we're more interested in dating the racial part.
Yeah. Have you talked to her about that?
Yeah.
And what does she say?
She knows about him, and first she'll tell me that, she thinks it's fine and I should just talk to him about it because I'm almost 18 and I should be able to hang out with people from different groups.
You need to move. What, are you going to college next year?
About a year and a half.
Junior college.
Yeah.
No, not at all.
Now, do you get to get out of the house and stuff, though?
Oh, yeah, I get out every weekend.
Well, see where it goes with this guy and then just kind of keep it under your hat. I mean, who the hell wants to see anybody? He wants to bring the boyfriend around anyway at 17.
Well, yeah. I always do. My parents are really nice, and I really
get along. Your dad is behaving in a way that he doesn't deserve to be included in your life. I hate to say it.
Yeah.
But that's really the way he's behaving, in a way that's reprehensible. And if he learns to put that aside a little bit, contain his feelings, then fine. You include him in your life. That's great.
And deal with your mom, too, and see if you can enlist her a little bit. Oh, listen. Listen, all you racist guys. You screw it up for all us semi-racist guys. You really do. You give us a bad... You really give us a bad image. You really do. This is what everyone complains about. It's a handful of you idiots screwing it for everybody. You really are. You really do. This country's basically good, and 99% of the people are decent. They got the 1% making the minorities think that everyone's racist because you loud idiots. Stop it, please. You're screwing all of us. And listen, if you want to be racist, fine. Just shut up about the whole thing. That's really my argument. Don't talk about it. Don't broadcast it.
Then just shut up.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Please, with the marches and the whole thing and the Klan hoods, you're screwing all of us. Jeremy?
Yes.
You're 31?
Yes.
What's up?
What's up?
Well, I got a question. What exactly puts someone in the category for needing to take Viagra?
When they have a medical condition or side effects from a medication that prevents them from getting or sustaining an erection.
Drew, okay. Did you just read that from a wristband?
No.
And the medical condition could be impotence. Is that's what you're talking about, right?
Well, impotence is kind of a nonspecific term. It is for erectile dysfunction of a medical cause.
Well, it could be of a psychological cause.
If it were profound, I guess. I mean, yeah, I suppose.
Why? What do you want to do with your penis, Jeremy?
Well, I don't. It's my only problem is I'm in a relationship with a female, and I cannot seem to. I'm not under any medication. I don't believe I have any medical problems going on at the moment. But when I try to just have prolonged sex, I can't seem to do it.
How long is prolonged?
More than 5 minutes.
Okay, and Viagra will make that worse.
You can't, well, hold on.
It might make you orgasm quicker.
Well, is he talking about orgasm, or is he talking about keeping an erection?
I want to keep my erection.
So you lose your erection.
Correct.
5 minutes into it. Well, maybe it'll
after,
do something.
After you orgasm?
Correct, no. Yes.
Correct, after you orgasm.
Oh, you idiot. That's how you answer my question? Of course you lose your erection. So you're orgasming in 5 minutes.
Right.
Okay, so good. Then Viagra is not going to help.
There's medicines like Prozac, medicines like that may delay ejaculation. But you just need to just ejaculate, you know, masturbate before you have sex or something. I mean, work it out with your girlfriend.
He's an idiot.
It's always the longest possible route on this show.
I know.
I don't know.
You have to be kind of a mind reader. You have to.
Yeah, well, sometimes I'm right and sometimes you're right.
Yeah.
Drew assumed that him saying I had sex for 5 minutes meant that he orgasmed in 5 minutes. Me, because he was interested in Viagra.
Well, also, he said, I lose my erection in 5 minutes.
After I asked him.
Yeah.
Me, who thought he was calling about Viagra, thought maybe he loses his erection in five, but we got to go round and round and round with the, yes, I lose my erection. And now, I don't even know what possesses Drew to ask about is after the orgasm, because to me that's
irrelevant. And why would I ask that? Yeah,
it's answered by the way I asked the question,
right.
But you're smart. You realize that everyone who listens to the show has a monkey IQ. and you asked irrelevant questions. And that's why Dr. Drew's Dr. Drew. Amelia?
Yeah.
What's up there, sister?
Well, I just found out today that I had mono.
Yeah.
Fun.
Old school, right?
Yeah, seriously.
You don't hear about that mono as much as you used to.
No, you still see it.
Still around?
It's going around a lot. A lot of people at my school have it.
How long have you had fever for?
About 4 days ago, I started getting, I thought I had strep throat.
Right.
And then I went in there.
Okay.
Oh, man.
All right, got it. Okay.
I wish I had mono in high school. What do you stay out for like 4 weeks, right?
Well, I'm hoping my friend Rachel had it for like 3 months. So
yeah.
I'm not going to have it that bad, but.
Yeah, but you gotta shoot for at least 6 to 8 weeks. Oh, my God. Could you imagine this, Drew?
It's horrible.
I was
utopia.
I had it when I was 18. I was so sick.
Oh, poor Drew. Drew, you had it during the school year?
The very end of my senior year.
Yeah, you were like watching the homework hotline and sending people back and forth. They're like pack mules to get assignments and stuff, right? Sitting at home with a fever, writing book reports.
It was actually during this period, at the very end, they called the senior project, which was independent projects. I taught myself to type during that time.
All right. I would have taught myself to masturbate even better, but all right. So, yeah.
My question was, my boyfriend's coming back into town, and it's going to be Valentine's Day, and I know that by kissing him, I can give him mono, but I didn't know if I could give it to him by giving him oral sex.
Absolutely.
Really?
Yeah, it's a mucosal. The reason it transmits, it's across the lining of the mouth. The lining of the urethra is the same kind of surface as is the lining of the vagina. So he can, even if he does something to you, he can get it.
Well, what if he takes a leak?
Like, first? No. Immediately after?
No, I'm talking about during.
During. Maybe if he continuously urinated during the oral sex act.
Continuous flow of urine?
That might prevent the transmission.
And what do we do? Just pop a hole in her cheek for drainage? Or
under
her
chin.
Oh, under the chin. That's right. Cheek would be, yeah, you're right. Smart. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'd pop a cheek hole for a breather hole. That helps drainage.
A gill.
Well, you know how it is when you're emptying a bottle. You know, when you buy that 5-gallon sparkless and you got to punch a hole in it in order for it not to get the vacuum effect in there. That's what I'm saying with the water, with the fluid drain.
Right.
Hey, all right. So that game off with the oral and the kissing drill?
Yep. Sorry.
Hey.
I know. No good.
God bless you, though, for saying, imagine this. You got a girlfriend? I mean, this is a keeper.
Mm.
This is thinking, well, we can't kiss. That I understand, but what about the oral? I'd risk it if I was a dude. You know what I'd do? I'd shove a Q-tip down, take a Q-tip, dip it in alcohol,
bleach,
shove it down there, and just snap it off. That'll stop it. Nothing getting down there. True,
yeah.
Seriously. But
yeah.
And I know you never have. You don't have any real answers. But what about the oral thing? I mean, isn't there much less likelihood of her transmitting this disease through oral sex on him than there is of them making out with tongues? Do you know what I'm saying?
It's a little more surface area, but I don't know there'd be any difference in the penetration of the virus, really.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, the mouth is not a great environment for viruses anyway.
Well, yeah. You think the urethra would be more hospitable?
Yeah. Yeah, I would.
He could wear a condom.
He could wear a condom. And then you'd get your desired look that you're after there, Adam.
Right, right. I like to watch the ladies. Amelia?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I guess you could wear a condom.
Oh, okay.
Don't get too excited now. Very thrilling.
All right, but listen, you're sick. You should take it easy. Maybe you're 17.
Valentine's Day, you know, I thought I'd give him a little treat.
Jesus Christ. If I got a piece of chocolate shaped like a heart that was, you know, measured 3/4 inch by 3/8 inch thick, it was a great day for me.
On Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If just look, that little sack of those crappy little chalky tasting hearts.
Valentine's Day is not for you.
No.
Not for the man.
No, but listen, who the hell invented those little hearts that taste like chalk?
Disgusting.
Peppermint chalk?
Yeah, that's for second graders.
Is that what that is?
So somebody was reminding me the other day that if you give flowers, you have to make sure they're sent to, like, the place of work, because it's important that other people see your expression.
Yeah. That wasn't
is that
me?
Incredible?
I just reminded, yeah, I just thought about that. Jesus Christ.
Oh, you haven't ordered them yet? Oh, dude.
You gotta order them.
Well,
your wife's at home. You just bring the crap home, right?
You wanna be
ashamed
of yourself.
Yeah, but Valentine's Day, the roses and stuff sell out way in advance. You gotta get in line right now.
It's great. You gotta hear me order roses, like, or order anything worth of flowers. Like, they're like, well, you know what we're gonna do? We have a boat. It's a wicker boat, but it's shaped it's wicker, but it's shaped like a boat, and it's really what we call the floral barge. And I'm like, listen. $90. That's the ceiling. You got it? Yeah. See, what we're going to do is we're gonna take some angel's breath, and then we're going to take white. Listen, save it. I don't care. 90. That's your lid. That's the ceiling. Get it off. I want this to look as expensive as $90 can possibly look, and I don't care if you spell it, if it's a swastika made of a black roses. Whatever you decide, that's great. Just make it look like I spent 100.
You better hope your girlfriend's not listening.
No, she doesn't. Nobody I know listens to this show.
Your grandma. She's going to be pissed.
With the goddamn work flowers.
Yeah.
And then you know what the worst is? If you got a woman that works in a place with a lot of other women, and you don't send something...
Oh, and it's got to compete. It's got to outwit the rest of the crowd there.
Well, not only that, but here's what happens. They're sitting there, and here's what you're going to get later that night. I saw the flower guy came. He came in about noon, and he had a beautiful, beautiful arrangement. And he started walking toward my desk, and I thought it was going. And he went. He went over to Cheryl Rosenblum's desk and dropped it off there. And I could not believe. And then another, and then another. Nothing stopped. Do you understand now? Now you're being punished.
Then it's the ones you brought here, the ones you brought home tonight. That's very nice.
No.
Very nice.
No, you're screwed. But you have to send them to work.
Yes.
So that the other chicks at work can understand that she has her man whipped like you guys got your guy whipped. And trained. And broken. Jump. Through the hoop. Through the hoop. Puny balls. Right through that hoop. No, I have a girlfriend. We're very much in love. No. Oh. And you know what? And then you hear these commercials. All these commercials now. You know, with the ladies talking. Chocolates. Flowers. That's not going to cut it anymore, fellas. I'm always like, screw you, bitch. You're lucky you get anything. I'm yelling at the radio. What's in it for us? You know, all we do with Valentine's, let's see if we can break even. Let's see if we can dodge a bullet. How can we get through this day without having our women pissed? That's all we're doing. A hot second do we ever think about anything.
That's right.
This is going to be a great day. No, you know what this is for us? This is traffic court. Let's see if we can get through it and get out without being arrested.
Yeah, but men, it is the most anxiety-provoking holiday for men of the year.
Yeah.
Men, first of all, we have no instinct for it.
Yeah,
and we're freaked out. We don't want to hurt anybody's feelings. And
well, but let me tell you
the
problem.
We know it's not going to be good.
Let me tell you the problem. You must, and this is your problem, Drew, you have not established yourself as a retard emotionally who is incapable of any gesture of love at all. Once you do that, then I better, you know, I could deliver a square foot of sod that was on fire,
and
it'd be a great day.
You're going to have your girlfriend's boot 3 feet up your ass.
Your wife expects things out of you. That's your problem. It's like I have a brain injury. You have to establish yourself as like a retarded.
Well, then she's going to get the gifts from her other lover.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
All right. Well, we'll be back.
Hello, this is your radio.
Radio.
LoveLine will be right back.
Yeah, Ace and his tinted shades. You know, the ones that are a little darker on the top and lighter on the bottom. Leather jacket, moving in slow motion.
I think they're darker on the top and lighter on the bottom.
Oh, what did I say? Yeah. Say that way around?
I think so.
Yeah, yeah. Moving through the crowd, hair slicked back, supermodel spinning and turning.
Your perm's looking good tonight.
Big A slugging off his foreign beer. Moving,
moving around,
bouncing like $1 million. Yeah, that's my life, everybody. I walk around my house doing this. Slow motion. Boots that zip up on the sun. Just can't wait to be rolled on down that chode again.
We should be able to come up with some good lyrics for that.
Yeah. Well, Willie Nelson appreciated my singing.
On the chode again?
Yeah, yeah.
I came up with that one.
Oh, that was,
that was pretty good.
Yeah, you did. And I gave you credit for that at the office today, Drew. Anne?
Yes.
You're 19?
Yeah. I have a question, okay? I've been dating this guy for about 3 months now, and we recently just started being sexually active with each other, and he can't get it hard. Mm-hmm. It happened once. We're in a car, you know, no big deal. Maybe it was uncomfortable, didn't pay any attention to it. A couple of times later, we tried to do and he couldn't get hard.
All right, is there anything we should know about him?
He's on steroids. He's this big guy and he's on steroids.
All right. Well, that's a common side effect of steroids.
That's what I thought too, but he could come. He came 3 times.
Yeah, possible.
Oh, man. And that's a mess too when your penis is limp. I mean, it's all over the place.
It's never happened with me with another guy.
Well, he's on medication. What do you expect?
So it's normal. I mean,
normal. There are many guys. There are a number I have treated who end up with flaccid penis their whole life after that.
Wow.
Well, yeah. So what ends up, three times the guy orgasmed?
Yeah, like within like an hour.
How?
Jacking off.
You were, he was doing it to himself, or?
Yeah, he was doing it to himself, and I'm here like, okay, what am I, you know, what now? And
he finishes himself, and
what are you doing during all that?
Yeah.
I'm just like, I'm thinking he's going to get himself hard any minute.
Oh, and something comes out?
Yeah, and he starts, you know, coming. Yeah. I'm like, what's going on? Once we had sex, and it was hard, you know?
Yeah.
We did it.
Right.
It didn't last long, but hey, we had sex. And then after that, I mean...
And what made him go for the hat trick while you were there? I mean, he went for... What got him going with two and three?
I don't know. I'm just like... Laying on top of him, I see him grabbing his, you know, and he's jacking off. I'm like, okay, I think, okay, in my head, I'm thinking, okay, he's going to get hard. He's trying to get himself hard or I don't know. And I didn't know he was on steroids until after. And he's like, oh, I got to tell you something. I'm on steroids. I'm thinking, okay, he's not digging me, you know?
Well, yeah. I mean, it sounds like he digs it too much.
Well, I'm still trying to figure out how he beat himself off
three times in one
setting, just in the bedroom.
Yeah.
And he finished, and how long after the first one did the second one come?
The second one, we waited until a little bit, like 10, 15 minutes, and then he went at it again.
And you're just hanging out again?
Yeah, I'm just kissing him, thinking any minute now.
And then number three?
And then number two, and then after that, another 20 minutes, let's try it again, and then number three.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I'm thinking, see, because I thought if a penis doesn't get hard... He can't come.
Oh, no, you can.
It's not easy. I've done that, you know, only when I'm drunk. You really got to work it. Really work it. And
when you're angry, too, Peter.
Angry. Yeah. Yeah. What's that?
And he's over here sweating big time.
Yeah, well, you listen, I do three push-ups, I'm sweating. Forget about come three times.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well.
And listen, it's everywhere, right? I mean, when your penis is limp, and you're beating off, when something starts coming out, it's flopping all over, it's spraying all over the place, right?
Yeah, it is.
That's a disaster
good
over there.
Good times.
Hey, well, at least he looks good with his shirt off while he's beating off.
Oh, man, he needs to stop that. So is it possible that he could be like that for life, then?
It's possible. I've seen some cases like that.
What?
However, this, you know, this is a situation where Viagra would be helpful. However, I hate the idea that he's taking chemicals that are not for his health, that are harmful to him, that are clearly having adverse effect on his body.
Right.
And now he's going to take another medicine to counteract that. But
why don't you try to get him off the juice, all right?
I already did.
Well, what's the deal?
I'm into my body, and you need to understand that.
Yeah, he's into it, but he's destroying it.
Yeah.
He's into it, but his dork doesn't work.
The other thing is people that are into steroids get addicted to them, so he may actually need treatment. And there's a lot of cross-addiction between steroids and other stimulants like speed or cocaine. So look for that too with him.
It's one of the most ironic things in the world that the guy who looks amazing with his shirt off, his penis doesn't work.
Yeah.
I mean, because really, when you really break it down, you're selling virility.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
When a guy works out a lot and he looks amazing and he's tanned and he's clean shaven and his muscles are rippling, essentially, if you really just break it down to its lowest common denominator, he's trying to attract women mm-hmm. with this physique.
Mm-hmm.
And the reason they're attracted to him is because he looks the most virile
mm-hmm.
of all the men.
Mm-hmm.
Yet, the penis doesn't work. He's in a pool of his own jizz going for number four there with the penis that is more like a fire hose that got hit with a surge of water than it is a penis.
Water wiggle.
Yeah. We used to call those water weenies when we were kids. Brad?
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey, you're 18. What's happening?
I just started going out with one of my friends. We've been friends for about a year, and we just recently, you know, discovered, you know, we both liked each other, and we decided to, you know, go out, try it out, or whatever. Seems to be working out pretty good, and we became sexually, you know, active like a month ago. And she wants to have sex, but she's a virgin, and she says she doesn't want to do it because it hurts. And I was wondering if there's, like, anything, like, that might, like, reduce the pain or anything we could do to, like, make it easier for her.
Coke. She's 18?
Cocaine.
Yeah.
It really shouldn't be that painful at 18.
She's not really she's had sex before. It was, like,
Yeah, so she has a different problem. She has vaginismus. She has She's anxious about sex. She has spasm of the muscles down there that make it painful with penetration.
Okay.
So really, most importantly, you've got to really take it very slow.
Very slow.
Very slow. Maybe not even be able to penetrate the first time.
Well, what about lubrication?
And lots of lubrication.
How about...
I don't know. I haven't tried it with her yet.
And No.
We're saying whip up some lube, you know, get some lubrication.
No matter what. Yeah, get it.
Yeah.
All right?
All right. Thanks, guys.
All right.
Hey, good times.
Yeah, all right, man.
All right. Drew, you ain't gonna satisfied. You knock over my second cup of water, are you?
No, I gotta make sure I hit the equipment here first. That's my goal.
Maybe a little lightning round coming up, everybody.
I noticed the cowbell's out.
Blah, blah, blah. Oh yeah.
Me.
Buckle up, kiddies. Got a little lightning round coming your way. Mary?
Hi.
Hey, you're 21. What's up?
The woman called before about Depakote. I had a bunch of friends that recommended the psychiatrist that I go to, and all of them were put on Depakote, and I walked in there, and he spent like a half an hour talking to me. He's like, oh, you're depressed. Here, take this.
All right. It all worked out, and everything's fine now, right?
No.
Right. Thank you very much. Can we go to the next call? I think she made her point. Right? She friends recommended a reputable therapist. They went in there, gave him some Depakote, and everything's good now, right?
Blah, 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 blah.
Is that right? Mary?
Hi.
That's right, right?
No. It took the depression away for a while, but it replaced it with anger and violent tendencies.
Yeah, so there are side effects of essentially every medication. So you came off that, right?
Yes, stopped taking the Depakote just because it was just getting so
bad.
What did you
switch to?
Nothing yet, because this man's entire office was just furnished by Depakote, and it's supposed to be for bipolar and not just depression.
That's what it's for. It's a mood stabilizer.
Because I'm just depressed. It's not bipolar.
But there's certain kinds of bipolarities where you've not had a manic episode. So it's something that's a judgment call. Maybe you don't have bipolar. Maybe the diagnosis was wrong.
And I've talked to a bunch of other people I know that go to him, and every single one of them was just put on Depakote, walk in the door, walk out with it. And is he just prescribing it because they're, like, giving him money?
Yep. I don't know. Listen, can't you guys all not go to this guy then?
Now that we've all gotten together and talked it out, we're definitely looking for other people.
All right, so get another evaluation and see what you get.
All right.
I haven't found another person yet.
In Phoenix, there are no other psychiatrists other than this guy.
Well, I worry that you're not going to be happy with the next one either.
Right.
That's where
the
smart money is. Yeah. But, do you have a doctor?
Yes.
Well, maybe you get a recommendation from him or her.
That's what I'm going for. But is finding an antidepressant that works, is it just a guessing game? Like, here, try this, see if it works?
They all have about the same probability of effectiveness. It's really you're looking more at the side effects and the kind of the quality of the depression that you have, whether you're vegetative or agitated, that kind of thing. You try to control the kinds of symptoms of the depression you're getting. But in terms of correcting the depression itself, yeah, it's pretty much trial and error trying to guess what the biology is you probably have based on the symptom complex you have.
All right. Well, so give it a try. Drew, is there any call you want to get to before we get into the lightning round?
Let me look here.
Troubled past.
Yeah.
Affect girls today. Huh? Real fast, like. Rick?
Yeah.
You've had a troubled past?
Oh, yeah.
What was that troubled past?
I was abused pretty much from the age of 3 to the age of 11.
Sexually?
Yes, sexually and physically.
Who did this?
My step-grandfather raped me from the age of 3 to 7, and I had a...
Perfectly normal,
perfectly healthy.
His son, my stepfather, raped me once when I was like 8, and from the age of 3 to 11, he literally beat the hell out of me.
All right. Are you, it's amazing you're not like a criminal now.
I pretty much am.
Okay.
All right.
To an extent. I mean, I've settled down now. I'm 21. I've got other things on my mind. I can't go around getting myself put in jail.
Right.
I feel as if I've sort of leveled off a little bit. But when I was 11, I was real passive aggressive. I just let everything sink in, and I didn't say nothing about it until I'd blow. And I ended up blowing up, getting into a real bad fight, and got locked up until I was 15.
Well, listen, first things first. If you got to freak out and kill anybody, remember who did the damage.
And, yeah.
Kill,
go get them.
Kill grandpa or kill stepdad. That's number one. Dead. Oh, good. Well, that's nice. That's the best piece of news I had all day, old codger son of a bitch.
Only problem is my little brother, who is like a half-brother, it's my stepdad's son, they live in Florida, and my little brother's starting to find his father, and he started to hang out with his father, and he's trying to convince me that his father's changed, but I still have this little tendency inside of me where I've even told my brother this, you know, hey, bro, I love you, but if I ever see your dad, I'm going to knock his ass out, and then I might think about forgiving him for all.
Oh, with the S word. All right, look, okay, here's the deal. Rick, no one expects you to be normal after the hell you've been through. You're doing much better than you should be doing, and every day is going to be a little bit of work. When it comes to relationships, do not get into your past with the girls.
No.
At some point, you can start opening up to them, but don't get in, not too fast, with the all the information of the past. You don't have to be ashamed of it. It's just going to freak them a little bit. You don't need to get into it.
With somebody that's not terribly exciting and just kind of go easy.
Fat, white, pasty, and boring. All right, we'll be back with some lightning round after this.
Loveline. We'll be right back.
This is the fascinating afternoon. Let's check the time real fast. It's 11:49 and 30 seconds. 10 minutes and 30 seconds away from the top of the hour, straight up. The midnight, the winter hour, the 9:07. All right, let's see. Let's check temps real fast. We're out of Encino coming in 43. Carson checking in at 47. Banning, 51 degrees. El Cajon, 55. Pasadena, 61. Norwalk, 44 degrees. Santa Ana, 45. Claremont, 47. Glendale area, and that would include the Glendale and Burbank area, 51 degrees. Encino, 55. Chula Vista, 60. And Eagle Rock coming in at a surprising 49 degrees.
Here, the wind's coming in on south-southwest.
South-south at four and a half knots.
Burbank Airport.
Burbank Airport coming in about 4 knots from south-southwest. Sunset tomorrow, or sunrise, pardon me, 6:37 a.m. And then sunset is 6:19 p.m. That's, of course, in the evening. 4:05, look out for slow and go. Also, look out for brake lights on the 118 mattress in number 3 lane of the I-5, and a jackknife bobcat on the 110. All right, so let's go forward. We'll check the time real fast. We'll be back with weather. We'll be back with traffic. We'll do a little surf report. We'll do a fishing report coming in too. All right, back down to the lineup. Fast seven in radio. Let's have the phones real fast. Speed up there, Jack.
Yeah.
Yeah, but the same thing. I'm Israel. I'm their partner, to Dr. Drew. How can we do you tonight?
Hey, how's it?
13 years old. Hey, check it, buddy. Let me check it with time real fast. It is 11:50 and 58, 59, 60, 11:51, straight up, 9 minutes away from the top of the hour. And once we get to the top of the hour, that'll be 12 midnight. That'll be an hour away from 1 a.m. and 1 hour in reverse order away from 11, which was the hour that passed before. All right, there, Jack, what are we going to do? Encino checking in 43, Carson 47, Banning 51. What are we doing there, Jack?
Yeah, I'm going out to
Fungo,
right?
No, yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. Woo! Yeah, all that Austin Powers stuff. Blah, 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 blah. Woo! Yeah, going out with this girl. What's going on, everybody? Yeah.
And then, like, I've been going out for a while, and so I'm talking to this other girl, right?
Oh, yeah.
Two-timing.
Yeah.
Two chicks in the same bed.
Do it! Yeah. What's up there, buddy?
And now, like, she kind of asked me out, and now I'm going out with her, too.
Yeah, you got juggling two girls over there.
Does your first one think she's your exclusive girlfriend? Have you had the talk with her yet?
No, I haven't told her. Yeah,
haven't done no, but Pasadena checking in at 61 Norwalk, 44 Santa Ana, 45. Go ahead. Slow and go on the 405, by the way. And look out for brake lights on the 118.
Have you talked to the first girlfriend about her being your exclusive girlfriend?
That was evident.
No.
Right. So you're just dating people. It's all right.
Listen, Jack.
It's good you're concerned about their feelings.
Jack, buddy, I'm the master. Listen to me. Ace 101. Listen very carefully what I have to say, all right? Let me tell you something about ladies. You got to sit there. But you got to think of normally. But you got to do shit. So you got to move your eyes and slow. But all that's happening. And then you tell the second one. Saying, Anna coming in 45. You know what I'm saying there, buddy?
Line two.
That's what you got to do. You want line two?
Line two.
Downey. That's the hotline. That's wild card line. That line two. Hotline starting line two. Albert, you're 19. What's going on? That's up. Ace Rock, Old Good Mother. Smack Dab, Light Around. 11:53, 7 minutes away from the top of the hour. What's going on there, buddy?
Yeah, I go to bed and I wake up and like my penis is up.
Yeah. I'm like, woo! I know what you're talking about. That's a morning wood, boy. That's a good morning. Got that morning wood over there.
Three things. The stretch on the bladder triggers a spinal reflex. There's also the congestion of a full bladder can add to it. And then the sleep cycling.
Chris. Plus, you've been dreaming about Britney Spears.
There's a dream phase.
Or in his case, maybe Charo. Rachel's alcohol.
What time is it?
Well, yeah, I'll tell you what time it is. It's 11:53 and 50 seconds. 6 minutes and 10 seconds away from the top of the hour straight up. That's midnight. That's 1 hour away from 1 o'clock. And then that's 12 hours away from 12 noon the next day. And 2 hours away from 2 a.m. And an hour away in reverse order from 11 o'clock, which is the previous hour. And Cino checking in at 43. Carson coming in at 47. That's 53 degrees away from 100 degrees. Yeah, well, that's what I was about to start doing, Drew. They ought to do the math when they give the degrees out. Ace. How long till 100, you retards?
We need to hear from the people that pay our bills.
Oh, yeah, we got to pay some bills. We got to check with some good folks. But don't worry, even though it's almost 12 o'clock, we're going to be back with a ton of show. Ton of show right after this.
Okay, so I know there's nothing wrong with me. So what's up?
So I was like you, and I used to think that these datelines were totally cheesy.
Why can't I meet anybody?
But I tried everything else and thought, what the hell? So I called the dateline and actually met a cool guy.
I called the dateline and I hooked up with some cool people.
Believe it or not, other normal people are out there looking too.
877-889-DATE.
LoveLine. 1-800-LOVE-191.
We'll be right back.
Well, Ace, it's February 13th. That's 15 days from the end of the month.
That's right. And really, if they're going to do the clock math, they ought to do the calendar math and the temperature math. Okay. We will take a little 22-hour break. And
wait a minute now.
Yeah, it's 22 hours till the next show. We'll then be back with tomorrow night's show. See how it all works?
Who's the guest? That'd be interesting.
We're doing the molestation show.
Yeah, we're having a policeman in here talk about forensic examinations.
Where's the guy from?
The guy we met in Torrance. Remember at that Best Buy?
He's not Burbank PD, is he?
No.
Those guys hate me. Okay, good. So, until next time, Adam Kroll for Dr. Drew saying mahalo.
Because I told you guys last time, y'all, I don't know if y'all is racial discriminatory or whatever
Drew
it is.
Drew doesn't like blacks.
This has been LoveLine. The opinions expressed on this show are not necessarily those of the staff, management, sponsors, or this station. The producer for LoveLine is Ann Wilkins-Engel. LoveLine is a presentation of Westwood One Entertainment.